My dear lovely children, this is the fourth practice paper based on the revision mixed up questions for physics. Before this video, I have already uploaded three more practice paper based on the revision of mixed up questions. This is the fourth one. And the first question of this practice paper is, which conductor has more resistance? Here the graph is given. This is VI graph, potential difference and current graph. Potential difference and current graph. So VI graph has been given to you and two conductors are showing there, conductor P and conductor Q. You have to answer that which conductor out of these two has more resistance. Which conductor has more resistance, either P or Q? P and Q are the conductors. From the graph you have to select which has more resistance, which conductor has more resistance, either P or Q. Question number 2. What will happen if the bar magnet is pushed into the coil, pushed away from the coil and kept stationary with respect to the coil? See here, in this question, one coil is there which is attached to the galvanometer, and we know that the galvanometer deflects whenever there is a current in the coil. A bar magnet is kept there, just beside this coil, a bar magnet is kept. Now question is saying that if this bar magnet is pushed into the coil, the first part, if the bar magnet is pushed into the coil, what will happen in this coil? Or what will happen in the galvanometer if a bar magnet is pushed into the coil? And second one, if that bar magnet is pushed away from the coil, if the bar magnet is pushed away, then what will happen in the galvanometer? And the third one, if the bar magnet is kept stationary with respect to the coil, means bar magnet and coil both are at rest, then what will happen in the galvanometer? So there are three parts of the same questions. First part is saying what will happen in the galvanometer, or what observation you will observe in the galvanometer if a bar magnet is pushed into the coil. Second, if bar magnet is pushed away from the coil. And third one, if the bar magnet is kept stationary, means the bar magnet is at rest with respect to the coil. In all the cases, you have to tell the answer about the observation in the galvanometer. Question number 3. What is lateral inversion? What do you mean by the term lateral inversion? Fourth, how does the word this look like in a plane mirror? Write your answer in answer sheet. Question is saying that if this word has been written on paper and you are here to find the image of this object in a plane mirror, then this word will look like in what manner in the plane mirror? That is, using the concept of lateral inversion, you have to write the answer. And what will be the answer, that you will have to write in your answers it also. Using the concept of lateral inversion, you will have to write it. Question number 5. If the magnification produced by a concave mirror is minus 3, what does it mean? If the magnification is minus 3, mirror is concave, then what does it mean? If m is equal to minus 3, means what does it mean? That you have to answer. Question number 6. What do you mean by aperture of a spherical mirror? What do you mean by aperture of a spherical mirror? We know that aperture of a mirror is denoted by m dash usually. You have to define the aperture. Question number 7. Draw the magnetic field pattern around a current carrying solenoid. If a current carrying solenoid is there, how can you plot the magnetic field pattern? This is the answer. By using a diagram, you have to write the answer. Question number 8. The magnetic field lines inside a current carrying solenoid are parallel and equispaced. Why? We know that whenever there is a chance to draw the magnetic field lines inside a current carrying solenoid, then the magnetic field lines are parallel and equispaced. In my video, I have explained the concept of current carrying solenoid. Now you have to reason, you have to mention out the reason why the magnetic field lines are parallel and equispaced inside a current carrying solenoid. I hope all these questions seem to be easier to all of you. If you solve all these questions, means you are in a better potential. Thank you.